If you can apply L'Hopital's rule, it works really nice to compute limits, as you will see in the following examples. Well, first of all, we take limit x to infinity of the ln of x over x to the power 1/3. We see an infinity over infinity. With our normal limit rules, there's nothing we can do. Fortunately, we have L'Hopital's rule. So if we have infinity over infinity, we can take the derivative of the numerator divided by the derivative of the denominator. So 1 over x, derivative of the denominator equals 1/3 x to the power minus 2/3. And then we have to simplify first. We have 1 over x, it goes to the denominator over here. Factor of 3, we have a 1 over 1 over 3, so the 1 over 1 over 3 equals 3. And leave the x to the power minus 2/3 where it was. And after those simplifications, so we cleaned up some mess, we get a 3 times x to the power 1/3. And now you know what the limit does. If it goes to infinity, x to the power 1/3 blows up. So we have 3 divided by something which becomes arbitrarily large. So our limit equals 0. So there we are. Second example. That one is a bit nastier. We have the limit x to 0, tangent of x minus x divided by x cubed. So what happens if x goes to 0? Well, the tangent of x equals 0, x equals 0, x cubed equals 0, so we have a 0 divided by 0, which means that we can apply L'Hopital's rule. So we differentiate numerator and we differentiate denominator, so we take the limit of f prime over g prime. So this one, the g prime equals 3x squared, and the f prime, well, you'll have to know that the derivative of the tangent of x equals 1 over cosine squared of x minus x, derivative minus 1. Or if you don't know that, you write tangent of x equals sine x over cosine x, and you just apply the quotient rule. And then we will need to apply L'Hopital's rule again, because what do we have now? We have 1 over x cosine x squared minus 1. Well, if x goes to 0, cosine x equals 1, so we have a 1 minus 1 equals 0, and 3x squared is still 0, so we still have a 0 over 0. Well, let's do it again. So what do we get? Derivative of the denominator is again easy, that's just a 6x. We have to be a bit careful with the cosine x to the power minus 2, that becomes a minus 2 times cosine x to the power minus 3 times derivative of the cosine equals minus sine. So that's the term you see over here. And obviously the derivative of the minus 1 is just 0. And then we can simplify a bit. Then we get a minus 2 times minus 1 over 6 equals a 1 over 3. So take that constant factor out. We get sine x over x. And we have a 1 over cosine x to the power 3. And now we have to look a bit again. The cosine x to the power 3 is fine, and for x to 0 that's just 1. And sine of x over x, hey, we know that limit. That's the standard limit. That one equals 1. We've seen that before. So now we can use the product rule, split it up into the 1/3, which is always fine. X to 0 of sine of x over x, limit equals 1. And the 1 over cosine cubed x, which is just 1, because there's no problem over there. So we get a 1/3 times 1 equals 1 over 3. So there we have our nasty limit, because we had to apply L'Hopital twice. And actually, if you don't know the sine x over x, you have to apply L'Hopital even 3 times in this exercise. Then we'll take infinity minus infinity. So we have to be a bit careful here. Because if x goes to pi over 2, the cosine of x becomes 0. So we get 1 over 0 equals infinity. And the tangent of x equals sine of x over cosine of x also blows up. So we have to be a bit careful, because we get infinity minus infinity. So what do? We turn it into one fraction. We get x to pi over 2 of 1 minus sine x over cosine x. Well, then we have a 0 over 0. Ah, but then we can apply L'Hopital's rule. Apply L'Hopital's rule. Derivative of the minus sine equals minus the cosine. Derivative of the cosine equals minus the sine. And then we can take x to pi over 2, no problem anymore, because we have a cosine of pi over 2 equals 0, and sine of pi over 2 equals 1, so we have 0 over 1 equals 0 for our limit. So, this L'Hopital's rule really works wonderful. So let's apply it in this limit as well. Sine of x over 1 minus cosine of x. Just do L'Hopital, we get the cosine of x over sine of x. Now, cosine of x becomes minus 1, sine of x blows up, so we get the minus infinity. But no, there's something horribly wrong here. We just did this L'Hopital's rule automatically. What's wrong? Did we do the derivatives wrong? No, the derivatives are fine. But remember, when can you apply L'Hopital's rule? If you have 0 over 0 or infinity over infinity. But if you take a closer look at this function, if x goes to pi, then the sine of x is just 0. And 1 minus the cosine x, the cosine of pi equals minus 1. So you get a 1 minus minus 1 is just 2. So you get something in the form 0 over 2. So this limit is just 0. So L'Hopital's rule may work as a charm. But be careful, only apply it in the cases where you can in fact apply it.